I'm in San Diego's part of the city, which is the Gaslamp Quarter. This is where all the action is happening. Nightlife, music, all kinds of great restaurants. And we're heading into one of the most important artists of our time, Michael Flohr, who is the urban expressionist. He's painted places like Gaslamp, San Diego Zoo, all over San Diego, the waterfront, and we're about ready to go into his studio. So let's go check him out. So Michael, thanks so much for letting me come out and check out your place.
Oh, yeah.
I'm really excited to see what you've got going on here.
You're
going to
get the full tour of the Flohr house.
All right. How did you pick this place? I mean, this is so different than your artwork. You know, you do these city scenes.
I think sometimes I'm in the city and I paint so many city scenes. It's nice to kind of be away from it.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's my subject that I can go in and experience and then come back and have some solitude and to be able to paint that. I think if I lived right in the city the whole time, it might be almost too overwhelming.
Right.
It's nice to come back and see the kids playing in the pool.
This is an incredible place for kids to grow up.
And we're 15 minutes from the downtown, so it's awesome.
Did you ever think that you would be back here?
No, I mean, when I met Melissa in art school, I thought, you know, I'll be living in San Francisco for my whole life, and that totally changed. I never thought I'd come back.
Do you think it's interesting that your dad paints all of these urban scenes, like downtown areas, and then you guys
living out
in the country?
It's kind of strange, but also it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
It's like the city, it's a bunch of stimulus and stuff.
But
right.
No, basically, I grew up in Lakeside in a small little town with a rodeo and lots of fishing lakes, and I grew up fishing and I was the kid who was supposed to never make it in life, because I was the kid who was getting the worst grades in school, could barely write, you know, reading was hard.
Why was that? I mean,
dyslexia.
What was going on?
So like, basically, that's how I start. I always, when I'm at a show and a collector asks me, how did you start? I always say, from bad spelling came good painting. I think if I moved to Manhattan, I might not paint as much, because I'd be so like enamored with everything, and I'd be
that
telling
makes
my
sense.
Wife, I'm getting more inspiration. She's like, yeah, but you haven't painted in a couple months. We got our mortgage is coming up.
So Michael, I think it's so amazing, you know, what you've taken out of San Diego and the fact that your work has shown literally all over the world, and you've given back so much to just the art world in general, and these pieces are going to go down in history.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, and to give back and doing, you know, I did that TED talk, and that was pretty cool.
Right.
Talking about dyslexia and all that and my struggles, so definitely humbles you. There was something I read about Monet where he said all these people wrote about what he meant and what he was thinking when he painted this flower, and he's like, it's just a beautiful flower.
Right.
Don't overthink it. So me, it's just capturing everyday moments that people see, and it's like just a little quick moment in time. And
well, one thing I do see definitely in your work is that you always have people interacting.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the human connection, the human relationship. And I see that just, you know, touring your home and seeing the warmth here with your family. And I see that in your artwork, you know, people at the bar all hanging out.
The best compliment is when people say, I feel like I'm right there sitting in there. And that's what I want. I want to feel like you're just this observer into this little moment of time of color and emotion, and
you capture it, you nail it every time.
You
definitely nail it. What I find really interesting about Michael Flohr is that even though he grew up here in the East County and he moves all the way to San Francisco where he finds his inspiration as an urban landscape painter, he ends up back here in the East County. Why? Because he's such a great father and such a terrific family man that even though his inspiration is urban, his heart is wherever his family is.